Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac, Victa Repentance series. Happy Thursday, Mosh Pit, and everybody out there. Hope your Thursdays are going off to a good start here, and thank you for the support on the All Items of Little Haunts run that we did yesterday. And, you know, it went about as well as I expected. I think it probably could have been a little bit better, but, you know, it's one of those things that maybe we'll revisit it after a balance patch or two. So let me know in the comments down below what you think about that, as well as today's meme of the day here brought to you by Ranix Rod, Title Thread Was, and Sissy Wept. Why are these spiders in my house? I don't like spiders. Hate the webs. Victa Senpai, how could you? You don't want to see little Sissy cry now. Come on. She's always happy. We'd never make her cry. No, never, never, never. And also, don't call me Sinvicta Senpai. Thank you very much. Ranix Rod and Sissy. C-Day is going to be zero Geo to touchdown Yankees goal. Well, we've got X-Ray Specs, Curse the Maze, the Trinket Smelter, and we've instantly been yeeted out of the where we were trying to go, which was the secret room. Good damage, but horrible tears rate and god-awful movement speed as well. So, yeah. Also, I have my hair for some reason. Although my hair is not really that long right now. I gave myself a haircut about a week ago, so it's getting there, but it ain't that long yet. Wooden chest here. So X-ray specs are obviously going to give us just an empty room. Okay. Interesting. I don't know why there's two barrels here. This is just weird. One of those new and improved rooms here, I guess. And we also have Mom's Bra, which is certainly an item. We'll start with 3 HP that will allow us the luxury of getting into the cursed room here on floor 1, which we normally don't have. And we get a movement speed buff here thanks to Goat Hoof. You know, it could be worse. 0.91 movement speed's pretty god-awful. Hopefully that, you know, we'll continue to get trinkets. I mean, it's nice that at least we get ourselves a trinket smelterable trinket here in the early goings that, you know, rectifies at least one of the problems that we have, which obviously was the movement speed. Now, if we can just get like the Cantor trinket, or if we can get, I don't know, I mean, even Cracked Crown at this point right now wouldn't be all that great, but it wouldn't be horrible either. Don't mind getting ourselves the piggy bank, as that is another very good item early on to have a little bit more of beneficial properties, as looking for sack rooms, that sort of thing. Yeah, Little Haunt was putting on a show, you know. I wasn't anticipating it being as good as, like, say, All Items or Succubus. But it was impressive enough for me to be like, you know, yeah, I think that it would be interesting to try to do one of those types of theme challenge runs after a major balance patch happens to just see, like, you know, what if we took it to the extreme, you know what I mean? What's going on over here? I don't like any of the movement going on over here. You just need to calm down. 2.15 tiers is just barely enough to hang over here. There we go. Get ourselves another Yabe. Obviously, we want to get a bomb so we can get into that tinted rock there. Shot speed also kind of a big problem here. With a 0.75. I'm not going to pick up that red heart yet because it's possible that we may get a sacrifice room. And it's going to be Baby Plum. So really hoping that we get a tiers up or something here. Basically anything other than a range upgrade. I wouldn't even necessarily mind just a regular basic HP upgrade, but I'd rather get tiers. Obviously tiers are going to be what we're just, like, praying for. If we can get our tiers stat rectified here, then we're going to be sitting pretty for the early stages. Now, this is not the end-all, be-all, obviously. You know, our tiers rate, our lacking of the tiers rate. Yeah, the lacking of the tiers rate. That's my favorite expansion to Isaac. The lack of tiers rate is going to definitely hamstring us quite a bit. And even if we do somehow get over that little hump, it's still not going to be enough to save us for, like, an entire run, you know. Oh, man. I'm glad that everyone hates Baby Plum as much as I do. She just gets nuked from now on. I don't know if that was ever, like, if that was supposed to happen, or if Tyrone deliberately just left it there after the G Fuel daily, but know what? I'm glad that we have something like that as our as a permanent thing here in the game. We still have no bomb, by the way. I'm still really hoping that we can get piggy bank. I mean, for being half priced, like it's going to be a huge sin for us to not get that. Obviously, speedball is a huge upgrade for us. It helps out at least with our shot speed and movement speed. So it's two stats that we were definitely lacking. It's not the most important stat that we needed, but it's, you know, it's two stats for the price of one. So I'll take it. And we get absolutely no bomb, so we cannot get, can't get the tinted rock. Unless if there's a chance here that we can get one more penny. We did, so it's not over yet. We could bomb this, we could bomb the donation machine and hope that we get 7 cents. And we just barely did. Okay, so it cost us our donation machine, but it was almost worth it, I would say. We don't have any more. We have nothing to smelt here trinkets-wise. So, you know, it's definitely a risk because obviously we're missing out on getting the possible soul hearts out of that tinted rock. But let's hope that we can keep our devil deal here. Another Curse of the Maze. So we get very lucky, and we do indeed get ourselves a soul heart, so that's huge for us. Then go into this golden chest, we get a range upgrade, a luck upgrade here. And we get Ghost Pepper, okay. Ghost Pepper is going to shoot out a blue fire, a blue candle-esque type flame every now and then, which is a very, very powerful tier effect, like that right there. And I think it's based on luck, I believe. Ourselves a cardio coin here as well. It's all before getting into the actual secret room. So very good start here to the second floor. It's a promising start anyway. We get a tier effect that's going to allow us to sort of stay a little bit safer than we normally would be. It also sort of compensates for the lack of tiers because it allows us to deal damage even though we're not firing. So that kind of secondary effect from a tier effect is just super good on a run where, you know, our rate of fire is completely bad. It's not partially bad, it's completely bad. Not the worst we've seen, though. We've certainly seen a lot worse than 2.15 tiers. Obviously, I don't want to continue that trend, but, you know, if it happens, I suppose. There's nothing we can really do about it. Go, nice shot there. Look at that. Back-to-back ghost flames coming out from Ghost Pepper. Now, it's in our best interest to go into the shop first here before fighting the boss. And the reason for that is that it's almost inconceivable that we would lose the devil deal at this point. Unless we just really bunged it up and took some major damage, which I'm hoping doesn't happen. This is going to be pretty important for us here. And with us having the trinket smelter, at least that gives us more options to get, you know, stats from unusual spots that we normally wouldn't be seeing. Get ourselves a golden key, so we might as well utilize that and get ourselves a half-price soul heart. And we're going to wait for Ghost Pepper to do this. And not get our penny, unfortunately. Judgment. The judgment here. This could possibly give us a bomb or HP or both. All right. Let's go fight this boss, shall we? Me Gemini here. Hopefully it's not the champion one. It's not. We don't want blue champion Gemini because it tends to be the faster of the Geminis, and that's less time that we could possibly have with Ghost Flame, Ghost Pepper, I should say, firing off. There we go. And because our shot speed did go up a little bit, we need to be careful of the ricochets from little Gemini, but should be okay. You know how to have control over your movement and don't... You don't need to rush these shots. Just be patient. You have the movement speed advantage. We've got the damage advantage. We do get a tiers upgrade, which is a huge, huge help to us. There's Gimpy as well as Jello. I think we're going to go with Gimpy here. All right. No sacrifice room that I can see. We have no bombs. If we can get one bomb, that opens up a world of possibilities for us, though. So it's in our best interest to go try to find a bomb over here. And there's one. There's a curse room, so it's still possible. Yeah, you're just seeing the difference that one simple stat up can make in a build here is really apparent with the Ghost Pepper. We got the tiers right now to help us out. Get free entry into curse room. I say it's free because we get our soul heart back anyway. But unfortunately, we don't get any bombs. And unless there was one inside of... Curse the Maze throwing us for a loop here. Get a Hierophant card. Okay. And a question mark card. All right. The Hierophant card we'll definitely use. Question mark card we're probably not going to need anytime soon. Oh, but you know what? We had the boomerang there. The boomerang could get us... The boomerang could... And still could get us this bomb over here. This might be worth doing. As much as I don't like giving away all these soul hearts, especially considering that we just got done buying one, we can get with the swallowed penny here. It's possible that Gimpy could also pay out with a soul heart, although it's not doing that. So, all right. Oh yes, friends. That's right. We just gave away 3 soul hearts to get the boomerang to keep this alive. Get a bomb. Remember, we have a golden key, so this is potentially a big time play here. Okay, we get more bombs here. I don't think the boomerang can grab chests, right? Yeah. All right. Double bombs and our soul heart. I'm not going to take the soul heart because I'm afraid of losing it on spikes. It gave us bombs and keys. Okay. Okay. And we can go with the boomerang over here. And grab this key. This two keys and one bomb. And, you know, I gotta say, excuse me? Thank you. I gotta say, that's some pretty big time moves right there. That's a big time play. You know, I didn't want to lose those soul hearts. But in this instance, I think it was actually warranted. And the end result is a resounding absolutely worth it here. We come away with bombs. Keys. We didn't lose that many soul hearts now, thanks to us getting one from the Tinted Rock. That was a good move. All things considered, I mean, there was definitely a more optimal way of doing that, especially had I remembered that the boomerang was in there. I would have done that all before picking up any of those soul hearts and using the Hierophant card. We could have escaped there with, you know, 4 soul hearts or maybe even 5 instead of the 2 that we've got. But for an on-the-fly adjustment, you know, I think that was a pretty good move there. So, and now we're in a much stronger position. We didn't gain any stats from it, obviously, but from a consumable standpoint, we're in a much more powerful position here to have like a little bit more spending money and a little bit more utility with bombs that we can use for like damage or whatnot. Now, people were seemingly confused on Monday's episode, where you think that you can bomb... You cannot bomb fires to create land bridges. That doesn't happen. Because people were wondering... They were hypothesizing about that in the... I I think that was the death certificate run. They're wondering how come I didn't go get Sackhead. And that's the reason why. It was inaccessible, just like Sack of Sacks is right there, unless we have flying. Now, this is also very tempting and interesting here that we have a sacrifice room. We don't have a lot of HP, but it would be in our best interest to play this before fighting the devil deal. Before fighting the boss, I mean. We get glitter bombs. Or, sorry, Nancy bombs. So what we're really, really banking on is hopefully finding an HP upgrade and maybe even a lot of red hearts. And that could just bust this run wide open. If we get a solid couple of taps here on the sacrifice room. And, again, that goes back into our selection of taking Gimpy. Gimpy has the potential to give us more soul hearts, which lets us tap even more, keeps us alive even more, and gets us more benefits. You know, on top of the fact, part of the reason why I wanted to get the piggy bank early on was this specific reason, in case we do have a possible sacrifice room play that's going to pay out even more dividends with us and get us even more powerful. So, you know, a lot of things are starting to come together. And honestly, that kind of planning, that kind of foresight just comes from experience. It's not something that you can really teach, but I try to articulate my strategies and thoughts the best that I can. Sometimes they get lost in translation. Other times they come across pretty well. End keys here. Only 8 cents, but I'm hoping that Gimpy is up to the task of giving us more soul hearts. Oh my god, that is a free super bandage. Are you kidding me? Wow. That is a huge, huge help. And we'll almost assuredly guarantee that we're going to get this sacrifice room to the max. Seeing here the damage or lack thereof is a little bit concerning. Gonna take super bandage now. So, we do not want to go fight the boss right now, because there's the potential that we could get a devil deal, and we don't want to use this HP until we're done tapping the sack room. People keep telling me that apparently you can also detonate. You don't have to shoot the barrel. Like, you can just hit TNT. You can just hit Minecrafter and just detonates for you. Oh my goodness. Get Diplopia and the treasure map here. Now, I don't remember if we're absolutely getting Diplopia and the treasure map. That is a guarantee because of the sacrifice room that we're about to use. Wasn't here. Oh, yeah, Sack of Sacks. So, here we go. We're going to play this down. Now, I don't remember if Diplopia and the mystery card actually works. The coins here do not get teleported to the angel room, unfortunately. So, we get a chance for an angel item or a soul heart. And we end up getting Miter. And Miter's fine. I mean, it was a free miter. I mean, you ain't got to complain about that. Go back and get these hearts over here. Now, again, I don't know if this is going to trigger Diplopia or not. It does. Wow. Okay. Mystery card Diplopia. Who knew? Spider mod here. It's one of those things where I'm like, did I remember that or not? Also, I shouldn't have bought that soul heart. I shouldn't have picked that soul heart until we're done with the sacrifice room, but hopefully we'll get the 7 soul heart payout here. There's the troll bombs. I'm not even going to worry about running away from them. This is a good map for us. Go for Uriel. Probably don't need to be fighting Uriel right now with these stats, to be honest. And we go for the 7 soul hearts and we get them. So I think that using Diplopia in this spot is an absolute huge waste, because obviously we don't need that many hearts. We're almost at a full rack here as well, so grab that. Man, oh man, you talk about Talk about value. Sacrifice rooms are there, man. They are. If you can make the play, it's absolutely worth it. And speaking of worth it, here we're going to get some Invicta robes, which is going to give us even more HP and damage. And there you go. You see me utilizing another trick there that I've shown a couple times now, whereas if you pick up ceremonial robes or anything that gives you a soul heart inside of a curse room, if you're able to walk out of the room fast enough before the item that you pick up grants you the soul hearts, you will not be charged for the curse room, and instead you'll be granted the full amount of soul hearts that you're supposed to be given after acquiring the item. Totally forgot that we had Nancy bombs there. We had Sty, and honestly, I think that us holding on to... We could go back and get the... could go back and get Sack of Sacks. That feels like a huge waste of Diplopia, though, so I'm not going to do that. We'll just head on down. Boss Rush ain't going to happen, but we're getting stronger. I mean, it's 18 minutes and we're in Caves 2, but hey, it was worth it. Tell me it wasn't worth it. All right, so I'm going to go just check over here. There's nothing over here. By the way, those health bars, HP bars. I was trying to say health and HP at the same time. My brain just short-circuited for a second. Those were given to us by Spider Mod, but that is not a mod. And also, I've been seeing it more, an increased amount of people asking, how do I get, like, the HUD and the charge bar and stuff? None of those are mods. They used to be mods in Rebirth, but they've since been added to the core game. And you simply access them, including, like, the smaller HUD over there. Just go to Options and go to Extra HUD. You can turn this to Mini. Mini Normal off. I choose Mini just so I can see everything over there. And then Found HUD. That's the stats over there. Then Charge Bars. I also recommend putting your bullet visibility on high. That way you can see enemy projectiles as they, you know, as they approach you a lot clearer than what Base Repentance was kind of doing for you, which was not very much. So just I've shown that before, but you know, for some reason I've been seeing an increased amount of comments about that, so I figured I'd show it again. Ain't no big deal. Don't mind. You know, got ourselves a Yave. The great block there from Ghost Pepper. Man, oh man. You're seeing the potential power here. As soon as we get five tiers rate or more, man, we are golden. Magic Fingers, nah. Nah, fam, we're good. Love the defensive nature of Ghost Pepper, allowing you to just block shots. And so the boss is gonna be to the left of there. Let's go back up here to the item room. Satanic Bible, I'm going to take it, but I'm not going to use it. There's no reason for us to. I don't want to completely ruin our boss drop here. So I'm just taking it just for the book drop. Careful there, big fella. Give me Rag Mega. Rag Mega.
Womp, 73%. Womp, 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 womp.
Hey, listen, game. You're the one making me work for all these benefits here. We are, speaking of benefit, going to get quad shot, which is going to absolutely wreck our tiers rate. But obviously, this is going to be fine. Quad shot is almost universally known as just a all-around damage booster. You get more shots. Yes, it kills your tiers rate, but it's worth it. in almost every single aspect that's worth it. Now we have items such as Cursed Eye on the table, which you might be thinking, like, why in the world you take Cursed Eye? Well, Cursed Eye and multi-shots are very powerful. And we haven't had Cursed Eye in a very, very long time. So I'm not saying that I want it, of course, because I think Cursed Eye is still pretty trash. But in this instance, it's still good. You know, looking for soy milk, looking for not necessarily almond milk. You know, looking for chocolate milk, that would be great. I mean, I would take almond milk just because, like, you know, everyone knows that I hate that item. And, you know, Invicta hates it. Everyone wants to see it, so just the way it goes. Thank you, Gimpy. I thought maybe the store was over here. It was kind of a long shot, but sorry, Specs helping us get a little shortcut every now and then. So because we have quad shot, technically our tiers are now going to be capped at, I think it's 2.75. So any tiers up that we get is going to be greatly reduced. However, if we get something like Rock Bottom, get something like Libra, we will be able to fire them at a more normalized rate. Okay. Sometimes there's a tinted rock in here. And I'm looking, searching on, seeking no tinted rock. Searching. Banana bum banana bum banana bum 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 banana bum banana banana. Yeah. We don't even need to destroy the keeper because we know that, you know, we're into. Now what I'm hoping for is the reason why we're not destroying the keepers, because our devil deal is 100%, by the way. What we're hoping for is Mama Mega on the next floor. That would be nice. Because then we can still access Boss Rush while still having Diplopia. And also getting those extra items that we want out of Boss Rush. Is it something that we need? No, but it would be nice. A Temperance Machine, no thank you. I always thought that Seek and Destroy was like my least favorite, one of my least favorite tracks off of Kill 'Em All. But then the end, like the ending half of the song is just so good. In the riffs that Dave and James were writing back in those days were just, and Kirk as well. Seek, I will say that Seek and Destroy is definitely one of the best Metallica songs here live. They usually play it at the end of a show as well. Again, this is not good enough for us to use Diplopia on, so we're just gonna keep banking Diplopia. Go back and get a red heart here for our bone heart. And unfortunately, there's no sacrifice room, so we'll just head on down, dog. That we get a luck upgrade and a freaking soul heart and dirty mind as well. I thought for a second I was gonna be cursed eye. I was about to lose my mind. Fortunately the bomb fly destroyed our chance of getting death list there. Death list of course is going to give us an order to kill enemies in, and if we do that we have a chance of getting a random stat up or consumable or heart. Just follow the order of the white skulls that you see, and that's all you got to do. Also very useful whenever you have enemies or rooms that have zero enemies in it, you just have to hit a button. Check up here for the store. Not the store. It's also not the store. Neither is that, so there's no reason for us to be in here, like, at all. Now there's sometimes, like, in rooms like this where Death's List doesn't even care what you hit. It's even if you go in order, like, Death List just says, like, yeah, you know what, not gonna happen. One of these rocks is usually tinted in here as well, and it's a super greed fight.
Super greed. Super greed. Super greedy.
Again, a sacrifice room would not be a horrible thing. We actually find the boss room. So we were, we were trailing by about 6 minutes. 6 minutes and 10 seconds. It's gonna be cracked orb. Cracked orb is going to show us random parts of the map, usually starting off with the ultra secret room or super secret room. So, you know, if we have the ability to gain entrance in there, that's sometimes good. I am going to go back and look for the sacrifice room, though. Because at this point, we're definitely going to need that. Wow. It's weird how one of them was moving and the other one wasn't. So Dirty Mind's going to help us out here quite a lot. And whenever you see these red poops like this, absolutely farm to your heart's content. More like farm to your fart's content. Doesn't make any sense. And that's just an arcade over there. So, well, I mean, the arcade might have a donation machine in here. Doesn't. So the Ultra Seeker room's up there, but we don't have any way of gaining access to it. Thanks to the damage we took, we also see where the regular Seeker room is, which is somewhere I would not have gone. I would have just gone straight to the boss room. But now that we know it's down here, was it worth it? No. Death card. I mean, I'll take the death card. Fine. All right. So it only took us 27 minutes to get to Mom. Very good, Isaac. And despite us taking so long, I mean, like, the reason why it's obviously taken us this long to get here was because of floor two and making the sacrifice room plays as well. But honestly, it was totally worth it. And we're definitely going to be doing a victory lap here. And, 36% deal with the devil. We'll get a little bit of a damage up from the negative, and we'll just head on to zone. I feel like it's been a minute since we've had quad shot. We got 10 keys. I mean, our tears rate's already pretty trash, so it might as well stay trash, but we get a powerful tier effect. The C-section, once again, is just showing up in places that you would least expect it to. Now, the difference here is that, obviously, we're nowhere near as powerful as we were on Monday. So, you know, this will be a little bit more of a truer test of the nature of the C-section nerf. Some people were correcting me on that they're doing less damage. They're doing less damage and ticking for less ticks, which is, I'm pretty sure that's what I said the other day, but I could be wrong. It's been, you know, it's been a couple days since I recorded those episodes. By those, I mean the patch notes video and then Monday's episode, because, I mean, here we are on Thursday now. Somehow we got a payout from Deathless, which, again, I'm telling you, like, it doesn't, that's the thing about Deathless is that it truly doesn't even care sometimes. Like, you can kill stuff in the wrong order, and Deathless is like, oh, yeah, no problem. That was perfect. And there's other times where you kill it in, like, perfect, like, harmony and unison, and Deathless is like, oh, sorry, I was taking the garbage out. Where were you again? Yeah, so we get a sacrifice room here, which, honestly, I'm totally fine with fighting the boss and then just going straight to Lamb. We don't need to fight Mom's Heart or Stanley. So totally down for this, especially because we're getting no stat-ups here thanks to Headless Horseman. You get a devil deal here, and yep. Not what I was expecting. Hey, we got a tears up. Wow. All right. So let's play this to conclusion here. I could go back and go get, like, the soul heart or the red heart from the bone heart, but I just don't care. We're going to get plenty of HP from this. There you go. You're seeing Bloody Gust here. Take off as well, giving us those tears up, as well as the movement speed up. Thanks to Gimpy, we've also almost completely recovered all the HP that we've been spending here. The 30 cents, which just doesn't even matter. Here comes Gabriel. And we get a golden bomb in here. Fantastic. Yeah, let's go check out the super secret room real fast, just because we might as well. We saw it the first time game. We're going to skip Shoal. I mean, like, we're only saving ourselves a little bit of time here. So the only thing we really lose is the possibility of a devil deal or angel deal and one Eden token. I'm going to actually duplicate this now. There we go. We got Guppy here and Maul of the Void as well. Yo. So it's going to be a little bit cramped for HP. A little bit cramped. What do we have another? Oh, that's I'm stupid. I'm like, why do we have two lives? But then I just remembered, oh, yeah, we just picked up two Guppy's Collars. So we just need to suffer through the early stages here of not taking any damage and just get some HP back, and we're going to be fine. All the Void and Guppy. So we definitely made some big-time plays in this episode for sure. And really, you know, all that early game decision-making paid off for us in the mid-game and is now paying off in the end game as well. So, and like I said, it's that kind of stuff. This isn't a humble brag or anything like that. It's just that kind of decision-making you'll just learn over time. It's not something that anyone can really teach you. We can show you, of course, but, you know, that it's neat to see a plan come together like that. And you all get to see and hear my thoughts and the plans and strategies as they, like, these aren't edited. So, like, it's as I'm going. They get to hear the thought process and all that kind of stuff. So down goes Lamb. No problem at all. And you know we're going to do a victory lap. Second seed, Juliet Whiskey Bravo 9, Quebec Papa Juliet November. So C-section once again taken off for us, although we're probably going to be mainly utilizing Maw of the Void. And really, a low tears rate plus Maw of the Void is a match made in heaven, because we're always going to be charging Maw of the Void regardless of what we're doing. And, you know, the subsequent random C-section babies that we throw out are just, they're just supplementary damage at that point. Let's go back and go find our item room. Nice Curse of the Lost nerd. Nice treasure map nerd. Blah, blah, blah. Justice. Hoping that we get some more movement speed. Hoping that we get some more tiers rate upgrades. More damage wouldn't be bad either. You know, for everything that we've got right now, our damage isn't necessarily impressive. And you know, in Isaac, I've always said it's an old Artosis adage from StarCraft 2 way back in the day, but win ahead, get more ahead, and that's exactly what you want to do in Isaac. You want to secure those dubs, you want to improve your win streak, want to get your win rating up, just keep going, just keep driving, and keep focused as well. recognize what you need to stay ahead of the game, recognize what you need to stay relevant in terms of your stats and your power curve and all that stuff, and I promise you that you will see a huge increase in the success rate of your runs. So get the new glowing hourglass as well. I don't remember where the boss room was. Was it over here? I think it was over here. Obviously, Red Stew is going to be huge, 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 huge for us. Do we go into the item room? We didn't. Sulfuric Acid is going to give us some damage. Could have probably rolled those, but didn't. Could also potentially use Justice inside of the item room with a reroll machine, but I don't want to do that. We get Bloody Lust, so that's just going to help us out even more when we take damage. This whole self-damaging build here is pretty good. The store again. If you're wondering what's breaking all these rocks, by the way, it's sulfuric acid. Need to be cautious around the bomb rocks, but for the most part, it's not that big of a deal. Oh man, down goes Dingle. Look at all the soul hearts that are dropping. Look at Dirty Mind just going ham. Back up here and go get our item room. There's not over here. There's a tinted rock, though. You're wasting our valuable Red Stew time here. I don't think double C-section does anything, but sure, we'll take it anyway. What on earth? I remember Tyrone briefly saying that they've maybe changed the item pool of C-section, so maybe that's the reason why we're seeing it all the time, but man. C-section used to be like super duper rare, and just now it's just not. We see the location of the Ultra Seeker Room. Not that it really helps us, because we can't get in there anyway. Demon Judgment. Rid of our red hearts there. Get us a little bit of mapping. A bit of movement speed, a little bit of tears are right there from Bloody Gust. Oh, baby. We get a massive tears up here, thanks to Skinny on Mushroom. We do lose some damage, but I mean, there's a certain point where the diminishing returns of your damage with C-section just doesn't even matter. Especially when you've got Guppy. Like, come on. Like, we're going to be fine. I'd rather have a much higher rate of fire than anything else here. We'll take this. High Priestess, nah. Queen of Hearts, nah. I'm going to hold on to the Justice card here. Only because, again, I want to try to find a reroll machine inside of a secret room. Oh, man. Dirty Juniors did not make it. Give me a movement speed up. And, well, it's, you know, we've got Damocles. I will take Succubus as well. And this is going to be interesting because we have not one but two Guppy's Collars. So now the real potential starts to take shape here with Damocles giving us not only extra item rooms, but remember, we just picked up more options, which is going to give us extra boss items as well. My God, you see the size of that radius? So Damocles is, possible big time pog here. Now we do also have a sacrifice room, but the problem is that I don't know how much HP we have. the range up. I also probably could have undone the damage that we took in there with the glowing hourglass. I don't know if that undoes Damocles's damage though, like if it resets the counter or something. I'm not too concerned about it, however, just because, you know, we have so many ways of dealing damage. Yeah, we've got two Guppy's collars, so even if Damocles does somehow fall, we're still gonna be fine. Age Dizzle. Sharp Plug, meh. I don't know if Brain Worm is going to even matter for C-section. I feel like it probably won't. Yeah, we get Squeezy and Divorce Papers, which is going to give us... Well, it normally would give us a Tears Rate buff, but obviously we're way, way, way capped. Thanks to us having Quad Shot. I mean, the only thing we really are looking for now, other than insurance against Damocles, is just more damage. More damage, fun stuff like, you know, us getting Libra or, you know, or really, any like the world is our oyster at this point. We can do whatever we want. It's a dominating victory for sure. Love having the ability to map here. We get a range upgrade. We have officially lost our red stew buff, which is okay. Jawbone and less than three. Of course, the glowing hourglass did change with the newest patch, as it now no longer a wild card. It no longer has an unlimited use. In fact, you can only use it 3 times per floor, and then it turns into the regular hourglass. Oh, Cat of Nine Tails, and I guess we'll take Matchbook. And take the Matchstick as well. We haven't needed bombs in quite a while since the first floor play, or second floor play, whenever that was. Curse of Lost. Oh my god, did you see the shot speed from that? This is an absolute shellacking. And again, it's more evidence to the fact that, you know, the change to C-section doesn't really feel all that bad. C-section still remains to be a fairly powerful tier effect. And it still scales very well, you know. I think that the change here, this is the thing. I think that the change to C-section was unwarranted just because, like, it's an item that it destroys your tears rate anyway. I'll take Renfinder. It's an item that kills your tears rate to begin with. So I think, in my opinion, that's already a pretty steep price to pay for it. You know, it's not the greatest item in the world. Crooked Penny. Yeah. Oh, you gotta love Crooked Penny when it does that with Damocles. Let me tell you something, brother. Yeah, we don't care about any of this. So, I mean, you know we're gonna do it again. I do want to take Mom's Purse, though. Get the 9-volt. Aw. It was worth a try, though. I'm a mega. Buddy, I'm trying not to destroy you, but you just gotta. See if we can go on a run here. There we go. Aw. Still worth it, though. Absolutely worth it for... Given how much, given how much of the... extra items that we got out of that. With Damocles, I mean, come on. Forget about it. There's Wrath. I get the Golden Azurade. Guppy's Collar. So that's our third Guppy's Collar. Now if Damocles falls and we fail this, we deserve to lose. Yeah, that's just all-time bad Zinvicta luck right there. You failed three coin flips on the Guppy's Collar. So I don't need the fool card. Take the Polaroid. And yeah, we'll take Twisted Pair for sure. The D sizzle. Oh. Oh, you gotta love it. Well, you know we're gonna roll here. And yeah. Forget me now. Wait, well, we gotta take Cricket's Head. Gotta have Cricket's Head. Gotta have it. Honestly, I'm just gonna roll for more just to see what else we can get. Alright. It's Tech X. Hey, Tech X is pretty damn good with C-section. Cricket's Body, it does give us a pretty significant tears up. Alright. I think we gotta go Tech X, right? Yeah. Gotta go Tech X. Pyro. Pisces gives us another tears up. So, you know, I'm gonna take that. Okay. I don't even know what's hitting us anymore. I don't really care. Not that I can really see what's going on, but, you know. Just having fun. Twanky Twanky. Serpent's Kiss. Don't really think we need any of that either. Kind of window shopping here. Jacob's Ladder would actually crash the game. I don't really want to take Jacob's Ladder. Take Host Hat. Yeah, we'll take Loki's Horn. This may crash the game. I'm going to take it anyway, though, but it's probably a bad decision. Well, I mean, we got to take Dunce Cap. Come on now. Let's see. Yeah, we can take Satanic Bible. I mean, we can take Mom's Knife because, like, we've got C-section, so it's not going to matter anyway. Daddy. All right, we got Bone Spurs here. Yeah, I'll take Yo Listen. Sure, we'll take Experimental Treatment. Gave us a Tears Up. Hey, we'll take that. Obsessed Fan. Yeah, we can take Rockin' in a Jar. All right. All righty. Here we go. Now, again, very, very, very possible this crashes the game. I hope it doesn't. Jacob's Ladder is just a menace. But that was an all-time legendarily amazing reroll there. And, you know, I don't know what the visibility's like on this run at this point. I mean, our damage seems pretty good. We made some great strides in our tiers department. And speaking of tiers, we're going to get more tiers here, of course. And we'll take some Roid Rage for shot speed. We do get spun. Extra special shout out to, honestly, Damocles. Damocles kind of made this possible, combined with the Crooked Penny. And also kind of the ballsiness for just doing the reroll there when we certainly didn't have to and probably shouldn't have. and get more range here. Not that it really matters, of course. Probably should have re-rolled that for something a little bit more spicy. I keep forgetting that we have the D6. Atriarch didn't make it. Now, we are getting through all of these doors here by way of sulfuric acid. We don't have anything special in terms of opening doors and whatnot. We get a devil deal here. And we get 9 lives, and that seals the deal in terms of those of you wanting or hoping that Damocles was going to fall. Spoiler alert, I don't think it's going to matter anymore. Binky here. That's not great. Neither is that, to be honest. Blanket here. I was kind of hoping we were going to get a full charge or something. Strength card. We can use this against Old Hushy. By that, I mean we probably don't need to use it against Old Hushy because he's already pretty much dead. Yep. That is something. And let's just go finish it off with Delirium, shall we? What a run. What a run. You know, you would have never guessed at the start of this run, with us taking so long just to get to Mom, you would have never, ever thought that we would get 2 runs in under an hour here. And that's something that just really shows you how powerful the second half of this video was. So this is where we're talking about, you know, those decision-making, you know, paying dividends, et cetera, et cetera. We're doing buku amounts of damage. We're doing stupid amounts of damage. If you like these kind of runs, everyone, make sure you click the like button. I really would appreciate it. I'd like it when you like these. If you like it, you like it. We have no idea what we're picking up here, so we get Sty and Soul Locket, sure. Why not? You know, why not? Thursday. We got Thursday Night Football coming up. Thursday is the new Friday, which is practically the weekend. I mean, hey. One of the best holidays of all time is on Thursday. It's Thanksgiving, for those of you who are in the States. Oh, Stanley. I'm not even going to bother moving because we have Holy Mantle thanks to Blanket. Yep. Up bombs and Magic 8 Ball. We know none of those are boss rooms over there because we would have seen it by now. And I don't know what's more impressive at this point, whether or not that the game hasn't crashed or the fact that Damocles has not fallen yet. I mean, the only item that I wouldn't be taking would be anything inside the secret room because of, like, you know, missing no. What's going on in here? Got HP up, and number 2. Got the very rarely seen, oh crap, transformation. Oh my god. Monster Manual, we get Bookworm too. Enroll Bookworm, and we get ourselves another HP. So this is going to be Delirium down here, so thank you for watching, everyone. I take that back. No, it's not. This just gives us even more ridiculousness going on here. Growth Hormone's going to give us even more damage. Even if Damocles were to fall and we somehow got down to 1 HP, we're still going to be okay against Delirium. With blind items, we can't. I would love to, for sure, but they can be missing, though, or TM Trainer, and I don't really want to mess with that. Got consolation prize. Gave us another tiers upgrade. My gosh. Arms bra. And toothpicks. Gonna give us a shot speed up. Not that we needed it, of course. We're actually clearing the rooms just as fast as it takes us to walk through them. Pretty remarkable. And yeah, the final room that we haven't been to is going to be Delirium. So thank you for watching, everyone. Don't blink because you may miss this. This is going to be one for the ages, I got to say. Let's see how fast Delirium lives through this. Here we go. Good luck, Delirium. Surprisingly, he's doing better than I thought he would. Down goes Delirium, no problem at all. And one hell of a run to boot. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, like I said, click the like button. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe, ring the notification bell, all that kind of good stuff. Hope you had a great start to your Thursday. I know I did because, man, that run was fun. Play those seeds for sure. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like the Dead Wizard One, Dennis Zubko, Ham Solo, Soaky Melon, Minty Sim, and Cajun Drifter. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find down below or by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.